Hey yo! Hello, welcome back to the channel, yeah? It's the boy Shingy, as usual. You already know what it is, yeah? What's up, y'all? Welcome back to the channel, it's the boy Shingy, as usual. You know what it is. I'm super pumped to be making this video, just like I'm excited to make every single video for y'all. But, so guys, I recently posted a video just a couple of days ago. I'm gonna queue up here on doing self-portraits of myself. Check that video out. It's a really good video that I just recently did, and you guys had a lot of questions on how I did the self-portrait. So I'm going to show you guys everything that I did to get my self-portraits, because there is a little bit of cool tips and tricks that I could share with you guys on getting your self-portraits done perfectly. So that being said, let's start with the gear first of all, of everything that you're going to need. I'm going to try to make this video as fast as possible. First thing you're going to need a tripod. Put your camera down there. That's going to be your photographer. This is your photographer right here. So you're going to need a tripod. Your tripod just pretty much, you have a plate on here. Put your 35mm or your 120 on here, and then your camera is gonna be stable as hell, which is what you're gonna need for this. So second thing, because we're shooting film, we're gonna need a cable release. You don't need this type of cable release. There's multiple cable releases. I like this one because it is super old school and super rugged, and it's long. It is extremely long. If you guys could check inside, the rope is extremely long, so I could do very long exposures from far away, which is really awesome. Am I gonna always need it? No, I'm not gonna always need it, but having the option is more than what I need. And next thing you're gonna need a light meter, because you're gonna need to read your light wherever you're gonna be. So last thing you're gonna need a camera. So it could be a medium format, or it could be a 35mm. But so just make sure whatever camera you have has threads inside the shutter button so that you're able to trip your shutter. So what you're gonna do with your camera is you're gonna actually connect your shutter release cable on top of your camera, like so. The longer your cable is, the more options you're gonna have doing self-portraits. It's not that important because you could hide the cable a bit, but when you have it longer, you're able to have a lot of room to do multiple things. You could hide it from the back, from anywhere. That's the style you want to do if you want to hide your cable. With the last shoot that I did, I actually wanted to see the cable because very highly inspired by Elsa Dorfman, and in her self-portraits you get to see the cable, and that's what I wanted. I wanted to get the cable, and she was really far. So big tip before we get started into the whole entire shoot, make sure you have a wide angle lens unless you want to do very tight self-portraits. I like self-portraits personally that show the entire scene or show wherever you are. That's a good way to get very engaging self-portraits in your environment, quote unquote. Take photos in your environment, kids. So with the shoot, you're gonna need to put in your shutter release cable into your camera, like so. And then after that, you're gonna pick whatever film stock you wanna shoot. I highly suggest you shoot black and white film. So one, it has a lot of forgiveness when you're shooting. And two, it looks really cool. For some reason, self-portraits seem a lot more engaging when they're black and white as opposed to color. So I highly suggest you have a color roll or a black and white roll, whatever it is, just have a black and white roll on standby and ready to shoot. So second step when taking the self-portraits, you're gonna need to put your camera on your tripod. I'll show this, but like I don't have the tripod mount on top of here, and I'm not about to look for it. So just put the camera on top of here. So the camera is propped and ready. What you're gonna need to do is get your focus spot on. So this is gonna be the biggest, most challenging thing for a lot of photographers, to get that focus on, or to get the whole picture in focus, quote unquote, to nail you, because you're not there to focus, right? You're not there to focus on yourself. So what I used was actually my pillow. I pretty much just laid my pillow where I was gonna be sitting, and then I focused on that, and then I put it back on the tripod, and then I went and sat right there. So the biggest key to this is, one, you have a general vicinity of where you're gonna be seated, and then next thing is you're gonna compensate for any missed focus with your aperture. So the aperture, what it does, the higher the aperture number, the more things you're gonna get in focus. So one, you wanna focus your whole entire scene, as well as make sure you're in focus. So you gotta shoot at a higher f-stop. So I highly suggest f5.6. If you use the trick that I just told you, laying a pillow or laying like a pencil or pen to focus whatever you have in front of you, where you're gonna be sitting, just focus on that. If you do that and you have a higher aperture, photo is going to be in focus. If you know any other tips to making this a better thing, this is just my process, guys. So you pretty much focus on where you're gonna be photographing, and then you take the photos. So that's pretty much that. There's not really much to taking a self-portrait, except that you need to make sure your aperture is quite high. For my photos, I did f8, and it was really good, but I also understand how it could be very dark. daunting because it is film photography, but those are one of the things that you could do, again, to make sure that your things are going to be in focus. So like, quick recap, you need a light meter, you need a shutter release cable, and you need a tripod. Those three things you really need, as well as your film and your camera, and making sure that your camera allows you to have a shutter release cable. Next thing you need to do, you need to make sure that you use a temporary subject so that you get your, you know, your focus. And last but not least, shoot at a higher f-stop in order to get your shot. Taking your own self-portrait, it is just such a beautiful thing. So given that this whole process is just such an incredible euphoric process, I highly suggest that you develop your own film just to keep it more personal and very engaging. You don't need to post these photos if you don't like them. This whole practice is practically for you guys. So don't just do it because somebody else did it or because I did it. The reason why I did it was to be more engaged with my content and to just feel vulnerable. And this is what self-portraits do. They make you feel very, very vulnerable. So if you haven't taken a self-portrait, I highly suggest you do. Like, it is so, so engaging. Do the whole nine, like come up with your outfit and all of that stuff, because you're not gonna regret it. It's something that I think every photographer needs to do, especially when you shoot film, because the whole process is gonna be very, very rewarding. There's no screen to look back to. All you have is just the moment of you taking the photo and you staring into the lens, which I find is very, 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 very important. So if you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button. If you're already subscribed to the channel, turn on post notifications. I'm posting a lot of videos. I'm posting like 3 times to 2 times a week, which is gonna be very different. And guys, I'm on my road to 10,000 subscribers. It would really help if you guys could hit the like button as well as comment down below on this video. It will help the algorithm push my videos to being recommended and all that type of stuff. So road to 10K. Thank you to everybody subscribed. You guys are freaking awesome. I love y'all. You guys are awesome as hell. Follow me on Instagram at shotbyshingy. Check out my portfolio at shotbyshingy.com. Check out my brand, waybetterco.com. I sell merch like that says shoot film like this. This is a champion sweater, so it is a champion jacket, light jacket, jacket. It is a light jacket, so it's pretty cool. It feels really good. It has weather sealing. It's got really good pockets over here. But either way, if you want to check that out, go check that out. Want to check out my presets as well? Go check that out, waybetterco.com. That's where you're gonna find all of that stuff. And last but not least, guys, follow and hashtag at WePhotoGods. We have 1,000 followers on Instagram, where I'll be checking your guys' work and potentially reposting it. And if you want to get reposted, follow and hashtag, like I said, at WePhotoGods. Follow and hashtag at WePhotoGods for me to check out your work and to potentially feature you. I want to be featuring to 1,000 followers, 1,000 photographers. Like, have you ever put 1,000 people in a room? 1,000 people are going to be able to see your photo. That's just insane. That is really awesome. So go follow and hashtag at WePhotoGods. Thank you guys again for tuning in. You guys are awesome. I hope this video helped. Enjoy your self-portraits. Enjoy the moment. Enjoy everything. I hope you guys are happy. Stay positive. Chase your dreams. Do not give up. Let's keep going. Bang.